Okay, 4612 Borage in southeast Austin is a house that I might want to try to buy here. I'm buying these things up in southeast Austin. Ignore that. They're not nearly as good as Mr. Dream Home. Listed at $62,000 as a HUD home. HUD will take 90% of their list price. So, whatever the math is on that. This is my favorite thing. Whenever you go to a vacant house, for some reason, the wasps love to build nests at the entryway. Whoa. Alright, what do we got here? This is a laminate flooring. Looks like we've had a leak from the AC unit. So we'll have to rip that out, but tile all back there. Really yellow walls, but so far no signs of any stress cracking or foundation as they suggest in the MLS report. So far we have to replace this flooring. We got some kind of an AC issue here, I would imagine. I can't see what else this would be causing that. I think it's probably something pretty simple to deal with. Garage, it's a single car garage. It's kind of a wide one, but it's still single car. Water heater and AC unit. So it could be either of the two that's caused that water damage. Most likely though, a little rust on this water heater. Really, it could be either one. This water heater probably needs to be yanked out. What have we got here? General Electric, good, the good one. French doors, be in reasonable shape. Let's try them out, see if they open. Yep. Backyard, here we go. So this is pretty common, a fireplace. These things, like you can see here, what looked like probably a rodent had chewed through there. They actually chew through the siding to get inside. So we've got a fair amount of wood rot on the exterior of the house, but this really isn't that big deal. A couple pieces of siding, it's trim, and it's pretty common on a chimney. I see it all the time. Exterior of the house looks okay so far, other than the chimney. More wasp nest. Yeah, this looks pretty good. Roof looks good. Dead tree. And a broken down storage building. And a fort of some kind. Alright. Let's see what we got inside. Ooh, look, another busy wasp nest there. Yellow jackets. It's a yellow jacket house. Oh, here's a neat little thing too. Let me show you guys this. Sometimes you'll see these little plugs here in the ground. If you can see that. Yeah, there you go. See these little plugs here, and another one right here. Another one right over here. What that is a termite treatment. So this house has had a termite treatment at some point, which in my mind is a good thing because Texas has termites. Most of the properties that I have owned or do own all have had termites or will at some point. So having a treatment done is a good thing. Broken drawer. Stove, microwave. Cabinets are in good shape. This red has got to go. What do we got over here? Utility room. Looks to be in reasonable shape. Interesting, two different vents for some reason. Don't bother moving that fridge, honey. We'll just paint around it. Nobody will ever know. This tile is pretty good. You can tell this is a really poor insulation job. You see how thick this grout line is all the way down. Poor insulation, but it actually is very straight. The grout lines are very straight, so. Green room. Just fine. Bad texture job. Probably made that closet bigger, added or something, because as you can tell, they did a really poor job of texturing it. He doesn't. See, look at
Now they did a poor job at texturing this whole room. You look at this texture out here, and then look at this texture in here. I mean, you can see a clear difference. So this room, whole room has been retextured for some reason. I'm not going to worry too much about it. It's just a bad texture job. We have a little half bath here, going into the master bath, which is in remarkably good shape, except for some broken doors. Master bedroom. You cannot see very well because there's no lights in here. Uh-oh. A little sheetrock damage here. That's no big deal, though. My painter can fix that up just right, or maybe just leave it open. You can see your clothes. No, not really. I don't like this at all. I really don't like skylights. Reason being is that they always leak. And this may be why the gentleman mentioned possible foundation issues. This is not a foundation issue here. You can't see it. Well, you know, it slopes a little bit back this way, actually. There you go, you can see that crack better running all the way there. And there's also a crack in the wall here, but typically when they run up and down, I don't worry about them as much. But you look at the way this one is here, it's not really cracked at the bottom, but it's cracked pretty widely at the top here. And then I also noticed that as I walk through this room, there's a slope towards the back. So what that means to me is that this house is kind of sloped off the back here. Once again, I'm not going to worry about it if I buy the house. I'm just going to paint it and call it a day. So there is another bathroom here. Wow, okay. Neat. There's another bathroom in here. I don't like this tile on the wall, but I probably would leave it. And yeah, see, here you go again. So this tile, you probably have to take this tile up and put something down in this hallway. But if you look here at this, it looks like there's a crack actually. You can see a crack in the slab. These tiles are clearly not very secure anyhow, but you can see this cracking here. So I would say that my assessment in the other room is correct, that this is a situation where the back of the house is kind of sloped off. Yeah, I can feel it in this room too. A little bit of water damage there. The back of the house is kind of sloped off. So anyhow, nonetheless, I wouldn't worry about it. I would buy this house anyway, and is a HUD home, so I might make an offer on it after I allow my wife to view this video. There you go. Nice little house. Oh, paying 55,000, whatever the math is, should rent for $9.95 a month.